Okay, good morning students. Good morning to all.
Good morning.
How are you? I am fine. I hope you are so fine. Right. So, we had finished the first lesson. Okay. What is the name of the first lesson? We had finished it already. The name of the first lesson is Clever Tenali Ramakrishna. Clever Tenali Ramakrishna.
Right.
So we had finished it, and in the last class we had seen about the prefixes. In the last class we had seen about the prefixes. Okay. If you open textbook page number 6, already we had seen what is prefix, why should we use it, what is the use of the prefix. Everything we had seen, okay, in the last class. Okay. So, why should we use prefix? We should use prefix to change the meaning of the words. Okay? And where should we use prefix? We should use the prefix before the starting of the word. Okay? Few letters we should add to the new word. It is called a prefix. For example, already we have seen IR, IL, IM, UN, next DIS, IN, DIS, DIS, all these are called prefix letters. Okay? And also we should use prefix. Why should we use prefix? We should use prefix to form the opposite meaning. Form the opposite meaning. For example, happy is there. Happy is the root word. Happy is the root word. The prefix UN, if we add to happy, what will come? The new word will come by adding the prefix un. Next, afterwards, what happened? Happy becomes unhappy. Happy becomes unhappy. So, here, we should use prefix to form the opposite meaning of the root word. Okay? Ichina word ki prefix uses opposite word ka that matters. Okay, that is. So we had completed. Okay, balance, imbalance, legal, illegal, regular, irregular, acceptable, unacceptable, all these. If you see there, so you can see. Next, comfort, discomfort, dis. Okay, valid, invalid, in. Imbalance, I am. Illegal, IL. Beginning of the words. Okay, they are called prefixes. Now, today we are going to see the suffixes. We are going to see the suffixes. S-U-F-F-I-X-E-X. Suffixes. So here is a, there is a clue has been given here. See there. In the story, we have come across words such as encouragement. First word. E-N-C-O-U-R-A-J-E-M-E-N-T. Encouragement. Next, announcement. A-N-N-O-U-N-C-E-M-E-N-T. Announcement. Okay. Next, arrangement. Third one. Arrangement. A-R-R-A-N-G-E-M-E-N-T. Arrangement. Okay, except confusion also, fourth one, confusion, C-O-N-F-U-S-I-O-N, confusion, C-O-N-F-U-S-I-O-N, confusion, okay, right, see here, in the story we have come across the words such as encouragement, announcement, arrangement, okay, arrangement, confusion, etc. You might have observed that the pot, M E N T, the pot. So here in this word, M E N T, observe this, M E N T, okay, and here also, M E N T, and here also, M E N T, and here S I O N, S I O N, observe this. So in the prefix we have seen U N, I L, I R, I N, okay, the prefix words, letters, those are. Here also observe M E N T, S I O N. These are called prefixes. See here. You might have observed that part M E N T or S I O N is added to the words. Is added to the words. So what is the basic root word here? M E N T is added to the word encourage. Okay, this is the word encourage. Here the suffix is added to the encourage. So afterwards it is called encouragement. It is called encouragement. Here also announce is the root word. Announce is the root word or basic word. So meant, M E N T is added to the announce. So afterwards it has changed announcement. The word is called announcement after adding the M E N T. Next here also arrange is the basic word. Here M E N T added to the arrange. So afterwards it is called arrangement. Next here confuse is there. Confuse, S E is there. Confuse. Okay, S I O N here added. Confuse, S I O N added here. The root word is confuse. This is the root word. So here added S I O N. Okay, observe this. S I O N added here. Confuse, M E N T. M-E-N-T, M-E-N-T. So here explain, see there. M-E-N-T or S-I-O-N is added to the words encourage, announce, arrange, confuse in the end, in the end of the word. So this is the beginning. This is the beginning of the word. This is the end of the word. M-E-N-T is added to the word in the end. Okay. So, suffixes always we should add to the word at the end of the word. Okay. Chivvaro, man add chestam. Suffixes. Prefixes in the beginning of the word. Prefixes ikkade add chestam. Suffixes end of the word we should add. See there. The suffixes M-E-N-T, S-I-O-N are used to form nouns. Are used to form nouns out of the verbs. Okay. So here we can understand. So why should we use or why did they use M-E-N-T, S-I-O-N, M-E-N-T, M-E-N-T, S-I-O-N. Why did they use? Why did they use? Because all these are encourage, it is a verb actually. It is a verb. Announce, it is a verb. Arrange, it is a verb. So if we want to form a noun form, if we want to change the verb into as a noun, during that time we should add a M-E-N-T. Okay. If it verbs very well good. With nouns ga marchalanukunnappudu, just simply if we add M-E-N-T, add just the noun I put. So encourage, it is a verb. Encouragement, it is a noun. Okay. Encourage, it is a verb up to here. So after adding M-E-N-T, it is called encouragement. So it is a noun. Okay, understand? Encourage, it is a verb. Encouragement, noun. Encouragement, noun. Announce, it is a verb. Announcement, it is a noun. Okay, why should we use suffixes? We should use suffixes to form nouns out of the verbs, we should use suffixes. To form the nouns out of verbs, to form the nouns out of verbs ante verbal ga unna vaatini noun lu ga maarchataniki suffixes ni use chestam. Suffix antaru, okay, suffix em undi ikkada ment 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 sl. So encourage, it is a verb. Encouragement, it is a noun. Next, announce, it is a verb. Announcement, it is a announce, it is a verb. Announcement, it is a noun. And arrange, it is a verb. Arrangement, it is a noun. Okay, confuse, C-O-N-F-U only we have seen here, but the inner word is confuse is there. So confusion, S-I-O-N we have added here, that's why it is called confusion. And also it is a noun. Confuse is a verb, confusion it is a noun. Understand? So the suffix ment and S-I-O-N are used to form nouns out of the verbs. Okay, here examples are given, so we have to write it. The word is word has given here. First one, improve, this is verb. Okay, it is the word. You have to write the noun form of this word. Improve has given in the textbook. So you have to change, you have to form this one as a noun using the suffix. Okay, then noun ga marchandi suffixes and uses. Okay, they are ment and sion. ఈ రెండు ఉపయోగించి మీరు ఇచ్చిన వర్డ్ కి ఈ సఫిక్సెస్ యాడ్ చేసి వాటిని నౌన్ గా రాయాలి. మీరు నౌన్ ని నౌన్ ఫామ్ ని తయారు చేయాలి. ఓకే, ఇంప్రూవ్. నెక్స్ట్ డిస్కస్, డిఐఎస్సియుఎస్ఎస్ డిస్కస్. థర్డ్ వన్ డిప్రెస్, డిబిఆర్ఏఎస్ఎస్ డిప్రెస్. Fourth one, confuse, already we have seen confuse. Next, fifth one, enrich, fifth one, enrich. Sixth one, treated, T-R-E-A-T, treated. So these are the given words, so you have to use the suffixes and form a noun. Okay, noun form change. Alright, improve. So improve, suffix ment taken, right, noun form. Improvement. So it is the suffix. So by adding the ment, it is called a noun. By adding the ment as a suffix, it is called a noun. Ment ni add cheyatam valla ee verb ki idi noun form ga maarindi. Basically it is a verb. So when we add ment, then onwards it is called a noun. Understand? Next, discuss is there. Okay, discuss. So discussion, S-I-O-N we have to add it. So already S is there, that's why we should use I-O-N enough. D-I-S-C-U-S-S-I-O-N. Discussion. Okay. Next, depression. S-S. Already double S is there, that's why we should not use extra S. Extra S we should not use. Already S is there, that's why. Should write I-O-N enough. Depression. D-E-P-R-E-S-S-I-O-N. S S I O N depression. Okay, confuse already here we have written. Confuse, confusion, confusion. S I O N. So these are the verbs. Okay, if we want to form a noun using suffixes like this, we have to write enrich, enrichment, enrich, enrichment. So here M-E-N-T added, it is a suffix, suffixes, all these are called suffixes. And why should we use suffixes? We should use suffixes to form the nouns out of the verbs. To form the nouns out of the verbs. And the verbs nunchi noun forms tayaru cheyadaniki suffixes ni manam upayogistam. Next, treat, treatment, T-R-E-A-T-M-E-N-T, treatment, here M-E-N-T-O-N. Understand? Okay? So, in your textbook, all those fill the blanks are there. You have to fill it. Okay, two topics we had finished. In the last class, we had seen about prefixes. This class, we had finished suffixes. Okay? So, in the next class, we are going to remaining topics. So, I hope you can understand. Those who did not buy the textbook, try to buy it. Okay, syllabus is going on. Okay? Right. We will meet in the next class. Okay? We will meet in the next class. Thank you.